In the world of football, or soccer for you Americans, a lot of hype is given to young players who turn out to be teenage prodigies. These young players, like Ronaldo, Michael Owen, Neymar, and many others, are those who have been able to make a huge impact on the game at the earliest points of their careers. Only a handful of players in sports history have risen to fame in their later years. These players aged like fine wine and rocketed into the spotlight in their late 20s or even 30s. Today, we are going to talk about five such players. So, let's begin. Jamie Vardy. As of today, I believe everyone knows Jamie Vardy, but that was not always the case. Vardy had played for Sheffield as a youngster, but he had been let go by the Owls and had joined a non-league side, Stocksbridge Park Steel, by the age of 16. However, it wasn't until he was 23 years old that he was first picked up by a professional club, Halifax Town. In 2011, when he joined Leicester, Vardy was 25 years old and he was an absolute stunner who helped his club promote in 2014, then saved them again from relegation in 2015. Finally, his 24 goals helped the Foxes win the 2015-16 campaign to become English champions for the first time in their history. Finally, he cemented his place in the hearts of Leicester fans when he rejected a move to Arsenal. Didier Drogba. If Drogba wasn't a footballer, he would have been an accountant, considering that it was the subject he was studying while a reserve for Le Mans. 20 years old, he still had to make his professional debut, as injuries had threatened to derail his career before it had even started. The first good season of Drogba came when he was 24 years old, scoring 17-34 for Gengum. He later moved to Marseille, where he became one of Europe's hot properties following a 32-goal campaign. Soon, Chelsea picked up the Ivorian, and it was here that his legend was forged. Stamford Bridge saw him claim 4 Premier League titles, 4 FA Cups, and finally a spectacular win in the Champions League. In 400 games, he found the back of the net 164 times and became part of the football legend. Aidan Dzeko. After 4 uneventful years in his first 2 teams where he could not make a name for himself, Aidan Dzeko left behind his war-torn homeland to go to his new club, a club that would make him the player he is today, Wolfsburg. And Germany. After a slow start in Germany, Dzeko helped Wolfsburg reach the pinnacle of German football. Dzeko, Grafite, and Misimovic formed a magic triangle that led Wolfsburg to many victories. On the international stage, Dzeko was dubbed as the Bosnian Diamond in a game against Belgium, and that name stuck. It was time for Dzeko to move on, as England called. He started his career in the EPL with Manchester City. He performed well in England, but was overshadowed by the likes of Aguero. And so he moved again, this time to AS Roma. There, Dzeko won the Golden Boot in Italy and broke Francesco Totti's record for most goals. He only kept getting better and better in AS Roma to become the amazing player he is today. Miroslav Klose. It's a bit of a shocker when you learn that Miroslav Klose holds the record for most goals scored in an international tournament, instead of Ronaldo or Messi. Then, the surprise is further amplified when you get to know that Klose started his career at the age of 21. He started out working as a bricklayer while he played for Hamburg, but with hard work and determination, Klose rose to become the highest scoring player of the Bundesliga and won the Best German Players Award at 28. A move to Bayern Munich won him his first title when he was 30. That's before he went to Lazio. In 2014, he won the World Cup with Germany and retired as Germany's top scorer with 71 goals and 137 international appearances. Luca Toni. Italian players tend to peak at a later point in their careers than players from other countries, and Luca Toni is no different. Making his first appearance at Serie A at the age of 23 and debuting for Italy at the age of 27. At 29, Luca was Serie A top scorer with 31 goals for Fiorentina. 2 years later, he was the most dangerous forward in the Bundesliga with 39 strikes for Munich. Hampered by injuries, he moved to Verona, where he scored 51 goals in 100 games, and capo cannoniere at the age of 38. He retired a year later. Well, this was the list for the top 5 late bloomers. Give us a like and tell us your choices below in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to receive instant updates from our channel. Till then, see ya!